Hello, this is Carrie. Before we begin this journey downward into the deepest realms of sleep, let's first take this moment to just acclimate yourself, becoming aware of this inner sanctuary of yours. So to begin, you want to be in a place of comfort, ideally maybe a bed or a comfortable reclining chair, because we really want to relax our body. Now, close your eyes, staying firmly on your back, with your arms relaxed at your sides, and those legs rested downwards. Take in one deep breath in through your nose, counting slowly to four, and one deep breath out through your nose again, counting slowly to four. Try that again. Breathe in the breath of the Spirit. And breathe out the stress of your day. Now is the time to rest, my friend. Allowing the body to just relax as you listen to me. And this story I'm going to share with you is about a dear friend of mine that recently passed. And I really admired his connection to nature. Some called him a nomad, a wanderer. And I really believe in my heart, where he felt the most connected was in nature, because how it made him feel. Because nature has open arms. Everyone is welcome. Everyone is invited. And there are some that truly honor this, because it's sacred. And so in this sleep story, I'm going to show you nature from the eyes of Grant. And so imagine an early morning. The sun is just coming up over the horizon. The birds are waking up. And there's that gentle breeze in the air. It's so fresh and cool and tranquil. And you step outside, and the sun welcomes you to this new day. You look around you, and there's dew on the leaves, on the grass, and the flower petals. You can hear the trees gently sway with the breeze. Everyone is waking up. The day is full of opportunity and choices. And as you walk around outside in nature, I want you to feel that connection. Where you belong. It can be quite profound. The sense of belonging and oneness. Because nature, it will not judge you or reject you or humiliate you or even question you. You are divinely perfect. With all your flaws and imperfections, you're perfect in this moment. And nature embraces you. It surrounds you. And really, it really speaks to you, doesn't it? The quiet whisper of the wind. The love songs from the birds. The warmth from the rays of the sun. And the ground that you stand upon is so solid, so grounding. It fills you with a sense of strength and purpose. And you move on, maybe to a different scene in your mind, where you're just hiking. Hiking through the desert in Utah. and the soil is so rich and red. And it's warm and sunny. And the rocks are so tall and majestic, and even tranquil. And you take the palm of your hand, and you touch a rock, and you breathe in that breath of life. And you really can feel the energy, the essence from that rock. It's full of wisdom, serenity and peace. Because regardless of the elements of wind or rain, you're always there, solid, majestic and strong. And you take in that strength now, deep into your soul, feeling a sense of purpose. So pleasant here. That your creative mind gets so sleepy. That you just drift and become one with nature. This beautiful escape from the chaos in our world. And at times, just being here is what matters most. Because people like you, Grant, you might have struggled with connecting with people. You question people's motives, their actions, their behaviors, their beliefs. And deep down inside, like all of us, you just wanted to be accepted, seen, heard, loved, and appreciated. And in this escape of nature, you have all of that now. Because nature is alive. It is thriving. It sees you. It hears a longing from your heart. And it welcomes you with those open arms. And you just rest here. In that truth, one with the beauty of nature and all its glory. And then you shift to the beach in Oregon, Cannon Beach, my friend. Where you came alive. The sand was cool on the soles of your feet. And the wind gently touches your face. Almost like a warm caress on your cheek. And the sun is beginning to set over the horizon. The sky is filled with gold. Pink, purple, and orange. And you watch those gentle waves, how they roll in, and the water foams and bubbles and swirls around your ankles. You feel alive. And all your sadness, all your loneliness, all of that searching just comes to an end because you're home here with me. And you watch the sun drifting down, getting smaller and smaller. And even smaller. And then everything grand sees, hears, or feels just blends into this oneness, this unity of coming home and becoming one with nature. The sweet embrace as the sky becomes an indigo blue. And the moon rises. It's so bright and full and magical, just like you, Grant. And the stars light up the sky, and they sparkle and shine on the earth below. And you are there, resting. In those stars, loved and adored, peaceful, feel that now. My friend, how you belong to how even though you might wander and drift and seek connection. No, that connection has always been here, welcoming you back to this place of oneness, connection. Pleasant dreams. And so stay here. Really feel the sense of belonging. Because you do touch so many lives. We all do. We just don't realize it. Because Grant, you touched my life. And I am grateful for it. And so this is my gift to you, my friend, and to the world, and to all those people out there that felt like you did and searched like you did. I hope that you all can see the world, nature, the beautiful way that granted. And in fact, this is his gift to you. And so sleep. A deep, wonderful, sound sleep. And it is so.